Which Robin is the most powerful? Okay, but how about if we also add in the Robins that exist across the multiverse and from Elseworlds? Welcome back, Nerd Squad. This is Top 10 Nerd, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight. Today we'll be counting down the top 10 most powerful alternate versions of Robin. Let's find out who packs the biggest punch and the biggest brains as we get counting. Number 10, Triss Plover. Triss comes from a pretty dark future where all of humanity, it turns out, is living on a spaceship, destined to find a new home somewhere out in the cosmos to settle. The space vessel she lives on is known as Gotham, and she works as a farmer on the giant vessel. However, she ends up getting pursued by the authorities and decides to join the vigilante Batman. He tells her of the fact that there was a malfunction and their ship is actually now off course. Triss joins him as his Robin, and together the two of them manage to correct the ship's computer, putting them back on a proper course. Think Wall-E kind of, but if it were Batman and Robin teaming up to fix things instead of Wall-E and a reluctant Eve. Unfortunately, despite being a kind of cool apocalyptic future Robin, Triss still turned herself into the authorities in the end and was turned into fertilizer, after she realized that it would take over 300 years for the ship to arrive at their now correctly programmed destination. Yeah, that's gotta be a pretty depressing revelation. Number 9, Earth 2 Robin. The original Earth 2 Robin was an alternate version of Dick Grayson, who never became Nightwing but instead continued on with the mantle Robin well into his adulthood. He fought crime alongside the daughter of Batman and Catwoman, Helena Wayne, also known as the vigilante Huntress. Being that Earth 2 Robin was from the Golden Age, he's got a lot of weird knowledge and skills because, well, Golden Age comics, including medicinal and surgical skills. Thanks, Batman. He also was technically the original Robin, despite now being considered an alternate due to a reorganization of the continuity following Crisis on Infinite Earths, and then again during Infinite Crisis, and then again following Flashpoint. Wow, that's a lot of resets. Though this version of Robin wouldn't be around to see all those resets, as despite his long list of skills, he died attempting to protect the newly formed Earth during the Crisis on Infinite Earths event. So he only lives on at this point in our hearts and in our old mags. And friends, before we move on to this next spot, if you are loving this list and you want more bat lists, I want to give you those bat lists, so be sure to let us know that you like them by clicking that like button, and hey, why not share this list while you're at it? Help us find the people out in the world that also love Robins. Number 8, Robin 89. This alternate version of Robin made his first appearance in issue number 1 of Batman 89, a new limited series that takes place in the Burtonverse. One of my favorite verses. As a nod to the fact that Marlon Wayans was set to play Robin in the Burtonverse before Tim Burton left the Batman films, this version of him is black, which I think is pretty awesome. Initially, Marlon would have played Robin in the sequel, but the team actually decided instead to have him first appear in the third film. You know, the one that never happened, as Joel Schumacher then took over, introducing his own version of Robin in Batman Forever. We haven't seen much of this comic book version of what Marlon Wayans' Robin could have been, but what we did get is to see the mysterious figure who is Robin, likely still named Richard Grayson in this reality, take on Batman near the end of issue number 1 and hold his own against the Dark Knight. And so for that alone, and the fact that I'm really excited for Batman 89, I felt like I should include him. So hopefully you agree with me and you're also excited about Batman 89. Or if you're not excited, hey, you know, let me know in the comments. Everyone's entitled to their own opinion, you know what I mean? Number 7, Gotham City Garage Nightwing. Nightwing in this reality is known for fixing up bikes and wearing a leather jacket with no shirt underneath. Sounds pretty sweaty to me. He is recruited to help break into Lex Luthor's compound by Catwoman, and the pair of them are also joined by Kara. His skills here don't just include fighting and acrobatics, but also his driving skills, which are pretty impressive. Aside from that, Nightwing also has his tricked out bike, which adds to his power set. In this reality, he is rivals with Jason Todd, who himself gets his butt whooped by Kara. Nightwing in this reality is different in the sense that he is more selfish than his main continuity counterpart, and is willing to leave others behind in order to save himself. Number 6, Damian Wayne. What would an alternate Robinless be without a few of the main continuity Robins, of which we have a plethora of alternates already, as the role has changed hands throughout the years? I'm not going to list all of the Robins here, so if there's one that you're a huge fan of and I don't list them, please don't be offended, but I am going to mention a few that I just think are the most powerful and deserve to be mentioned, with some powerful Robin alternates from other realities and Elseworlds peppered in the mix there. Damian, of course, being one of those main Robins that I would like to talk to you about. Damian Wayne is another Robin who initially didn't have a problem with killing his opponents. This is due to the fact that he was raised among the League of Assassins, in part training with his mother, Talia al Ghul, herself a masterful and accomplished assassin and fighter. Damian has recently left the Robin mantle and his father's side to seemingly find himself in his own new Robin series. Although the series is called Robin, Damian claims to have turned his back on the bat and is looking to find out who he really is outside of his father's shadow, turning to his mother for some guidance this time around, and also looking inside himself. Which I think, you know, Damian's still pretty young, so that makes a lot of sense to me. Number 5. Deathlok. Deathlok is the Amalgam Universe version of Jason Todd. He is a combination of DC's Jason Todd, who was once known as Robin, Marvel's Midnight, and Marvel's Deathlok. In the Amalgam Universe, however, his name still remains Jason Todd, just to be clear. Jason was caught in an explosion and recovered by the villainous organization Hydra, who healed him and repaired him by turning him into a cyborg, making him into their agent and Deathlok. But prior to this, Jason was already a skilled fighter, albeit somewhat reckless, taking up the mantle of Moonwing when he worked for SHIELD, after Dick had left the mantle and SHIELD to go attend university. However, Jason would later be dismissed from SHIELD after making a grievous mistake while on duty, a mistake that even as Deathlok he still blamed his superiors for, confronting both Dick Grayson and SHIELD director Bruce Wayne during a fight later on. Number 4. Jason Todd. When it comes to Jason Todd, he is powerful because he doesn't often hold back and he doesn't really give up. While he may have trauma that sometimes can leave him vulnerable, his redefinition of the Bat Family moral code means that he's a touch more ruthless than your standard Robin. Okay, maybe a lot more ruthless. At least more ruthless after he left the mantle of Robin and became Red Hood. However, even during his time as Robin, Jason was a determined young man who, even when beaten, would never back down or give up in a fight. Currently, however, Jason is also a masterful sword fighter and weapons expert who is not afraid to kill those who get in his way, which is kind of what gives him an edge, I think, in comparison to some of the other Robins. Number 3. Robin King. Robin King is actually not an alternate version of any of our Robins from the main continuity. Gasp! Instead, Robin King is an alternate version of Bruce Wayne, who was inspired by a Robin's cheerful song at his parents' funeral in this reality. It was the young Bruce Wayne here who killed his parents due to the fact that he was inherently prone to violence and homicidal tendencies, even from a young age. Because this version of Robin is so murderous and dangerous, he could definitely be one of the most powerful Robins out there. Also, if you thought Jason had at times questionable morals or methods, the Robin King truly just blows him out of the water for that. Number 2. Dick Grayson. I think Dick has proven to be the most capable and powerful version of Robin that we've ever seen. This is likely thanks to a combination of Nightwing's personality and years of experience, considering that he was the very first Robin and has been around since the early days of Batman's vigilante career. He's also super flexible. I think he's also the most flexible Robin, which I know y'all might be thinking that doesn't equal power, but trust me, flexibility is hard and it is very powerful, I think. Do not underestimate someone who's very flexible. Dick even proved himself as a good fit as Bruce's heir when he himself took up the cape and cowl, filling in as Batman after he was presumed dead, but was really just MIA. Nightwing brings to the table not only his skills as a fighter and acrobat, but also his sharp wit as a perceptive and smart detective, as well as his forensic skills, or as I said once, his chemist skills. I called him a chemist once and people were like, that's not a thing. But he does have forensic skills, which is chemistry, so I feel like it still kind of goes hand in hand. I defend it. I would say when it comes to all-around Robin power, Nightwing is one of the most balanced, which generally gives him a leg up in comparison to the other Robins, who tend to dominate in a specific area, but usually lack somewhat in another. Basically, they're usually really good at like one or two things, but everything else, there's like, they're fluctuating. And I feel like Nightwing is pretty much like here, like he's just really good at a lot of stuff. Number 1. Dragon Slayer. Dragon Slayer is probably the most powerful of the Robins that we've seen so far. He's also definitely the most metal. He comes from the Dark Multiverse, more specifically, the Dark Multiverse Dark Knight's metal series. He actually sort of has powers as well, coming with an electric guitar that also happens to be an axe. He plays it with a kryptonite pick, using its sound to create sonic blasts and even energy constructs. And okay, yeah, so he doesn't necessarily have powers, but he is a powerful weapon, so I'm gonna count it, because it's like magically powerful. Dragon Slayer's Nightwing, aka Richard Grayson, is definitely the most badass of all the Robins here, and despite his very brief appearance, is in theory the most powerful. At least his brief appearance by comparison to some of the other ones. Although Tris Plover was also brief. Who do you think is the most powerful Robin? Which dark multiverse realities, Elseworlds, or alternate futures are your favorite? Which alternate Robin do you think would make the best Batman? From the multiverse, my friends, let me know. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. This has been Top 10 Nerd, and I am your host, Amanda McKnight. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, you stay nerdy, YouTube.